Hello React Native developers, I hope you are well. William here, recording from beautiful Zurich, Switzerland. Last week, Expo released SDK version 41, and in this video, I would like to cover three of the modules which were upgraded part of this new release, as well as a new way to build your managed apps via Expo application services that will produce dramatically smaller binaries. In fact, I tried this new method on React Native Elements, which is using quite a bit of Expo modules, and I received a binary app size up to 5 times smaller. Let's have a look. Thank you to Expo for sponsoring this video. I've always been an Expo enthusiast, leveraging it in my React Native projects to have web development like agility. And I am quite excited about the roadmap of the Expo project, where they're working on making all sorts of React Native projects converging towards the same models and same development workflows, whether it's a managed app via Expo Go or a React Native project that is using native code. More on that later. As always, you can use Expo Init to create a new SDK 41 project or use Expo Upgrade to upgrade your existing project to SDK 41. Now, 10 months after its first public announcement, reanimated version 2 is now a stable release, and version 41 ships version 2.1. If you are coming from SDK 40, which was shipping release candidate version 0, not much has changed. The most noticeable difference is around the type definitions. The use shared value hook has an improved type definition. Use animated style and use animated props have a much more precise types. Now they're quite delightful to use. And another function which has a revamped type is create animated component. So if you're using things like animated flatlist or SVG animations, you're gonna really enjoy the new precision in the type definition. I've been having a really good time so far with the type definitions in Reanimated 2. I used to maintain patches on the type definitions in my project, but now it seems to be in a really good shape. If you are coming from Reanimated V1, this version will upgrade your Reanimated project to version 2 because it is now a stable release. Version 2 is completely backward compatible with version 1, except for Interpolate, which has been renamed to Interpolate Node, so that the Interpolate function can be an animation worklet. And this is the kind of situations where TypeScript comes in very handy. And if you want to incrementally upgrade your project to Reanimated V2, which I recommend you do, you need to install the Reanimated Babel plugin in your configuration file. Now, if you are coming from the version 2 release candidate, there is not much to do. In fact, you can even remove the experiment directive from your app.json. Another noteworthy module upgrade is React Native Screens, which is used by React Native Navigation for two things. First, to provide the Create Native Navigation stack, which is using behind the scenes the UI navigation controller on iOS and the Fragment API on Android to truly provide native navigation performance. And then it is also used to offload part of the navigation tree from the JavaScript thread, namely the parts which are not visible to the user. The novelty in version 3 is that React Native Screens is now enabled by default, making it the default experience for Create Navigation Stack and making Create Native Navigation Stack available by default. So a nice step toward performant navigation experiences. Finally, React Native Loti has been upgraded to its latest version, and I know that it's a change that a lot of developers were looking forward to be able to run any kinds of Loti animation, even the one which were exported with the latest versions of body moving. So you should be now able to run any kind of Loti animations in your apps. In the latest Expo unboxing video, the theme was to bridge the gap between managed Expo apps and bare projects, and version 41 is bringing us one step closer. One of the big novelty now is that you can use EAS build to build your managed apps instead of using Expo build, and this will result in dramatically smaller app size. Expo build is using a template app, which they call, I think, a shell, that contains all of the Expo module available, and in Expo application services, it will only use the Expo modules that you need. I tried to build my React Native Elements project, which is using quite a bit of Expo modules using Expo application services, and that resulted into app sizes up to 5 times smaller. So I feel like a lot of developers are going to enjoy this new feature. And as always, the user experience to build the app via Expo application services was absolutely spotless. I was guided through all the steps nicely, and my iOS credentials, for instance, and distribution certificates were managed super nicely. It was quite delightful to use. I am pretty excited about these new development workflows. And last week during React Summit, Brent Vatney shared Expo's plans for the future. These plans include the capability to build a custom Expo Go client that will contain the custom modules which are using native code that you need. So you will be able to leverage the agility of the Expo Go development experience with the flexibility of having your own React Native modules which leverage native code. We'll have to wait a bit for this feature to be available, but I feel that this will have a tremendous impact in our development workflows. I always like to compare Expo and TypeScript, where a couple of years ago to use TypeScript in your React Native project was a substantial decision because a TypeScript React Native project would look quite different from a vanilla React Native project. And now with the Babel integration, it's a completely frictionless integration. And I feel like Expo is converging towards the same vision of making it completely frictionless. So instead of having React Native CLI projects, Expo managed app, Expo bare apps with native code, we'll just have in the future React Native projects. And I am pretty excited about this vision. Guys, let me know what you think about SDK version 41 in the comments below. Happy upgrading. I am looking forward to talk to you soon. And until next time, happy hacking. I believe that everything happens for a reason. I believe that there is greatness inside all of us. Best believe what you believe is what you will.